What you do is simple. Have a clear plan of a long-term goal that you're gonna go with and stick by it. Do what we call dollar cost averaging, where you contribute every single month and ensure that you are very consistent with it. That's the only way you're gonna make money from the stock market. Hey people, welcome to Ken's Money Matters once again. Pleasure to have you as usual, guys. Anyway, today I'm going back to Money Matters basics. I know I've been giving a lot of videos on traveling. I've done a lot of videos that I haven't posted on money and life in the diaspora. Now today, let's go back to the foundation of everything, which is stocks. My love for stocks is just immeasurable, guys. I love investing in stocks. It makes investing efficient. It makes investing easy. It makes it effective. And it is one area that we, as black people, are lagging behind, and we have to say it as it is. We have a single track way of thinking. If you get money, you're thinking of buying land, you're thinking of building a house at home, even those in the diaspora, you're thinking of, you know, buying a car. We have a very linear way of thinking when it comes to investments. And that is why I'm here, and we're going to go in this journey together, trying to diversify our investments, diversify our minds, diversify our thoughts, so that we can do different things. I'm not saying it's bad to buy land, houses, and cars. I'm only saying that we should have other options too. So today we're going to look at some of the basic ideas or basic information for those who want to start investing in the stock market. Like I say, investing in the stock market is really rewarding. It's something that has been studied historically. And if you invest consistently with a long-term outlook, you will get very good returns. Like I said, even just by this year alone, the market went down completely and rebounced back again. So those who ran out of the market lost a lot of money. But what I'm saying is very simple. I'm going to give you certain simple ideas that you need to have for you to successfully invest in the stock market. And shout out to bankrate.com, which is one of the websites of personal finance. It's an amazing website. I got some of the information, you know, from there when I was doing my research for the video. Anyway, I've added some of mine from different sites, from different books, and I've come up with these 9 basic ideas for stock market investors who want to just begin the journey of investing. Number one, you must know what kind of investor are you. A lot of our people do not even know about stock market. We don't even know what to expect. We don't even know what returns to expect. But if you get to know what kind of investor are you, you get to know if you are a good match for the stock market. Because the stock market is not for everybody. Each and every person have a way in which they invest. Each and every person have a way in which they want their returns to come. So the stock market isn't for everyone. So you must know what's your personality when it comes to investing. How do you expect your returns? How do you expect things to go? And how do you expect to do this investment as a whole? So you have to just know what kind of investor are you. It helps a lot in knowing who are you. What's your personality type? Are you patient enough that you can have that long-term view in the stock market? And are you also someone who can take in risks? Because the stock market is a very risky investment. Sometimes it goes down and your investment is eaten into properly. And of course, you have to be patient enough to wait for it to go back up. So are you patient enough? Are you able to take the risk that the stock market comes with? Number two, you must know what kind of investments you want to buy. The stock market, like I say, it's a big, big market. So you must know what are the specific investments you want to buy. Do you want to do some, you know, choose some companies, which again, I will advise against for beginners. How do you want to invest? Do you want to do what we call index fund investing, which I have actually done a video on. So, you know, you want to track a particular index, for example, the S&P 500, which is the most popular one. Do you want to be tracking it consistently and get the returns based on the movement of the market? Or how do you want to invest? Do you want to do what you call dividend investing? Do you want to do what you call value investing? Do you want to do what you call fundamental investing? So there are different types of investment, and there are different ways in which you can invest in the stock market alone. So you must know what kind of investments you want to buy or you want to get involved in. So it is important to have that information, know what you want. Most of the time for beginners, I just say simply track the market, track an index. If you, for example, in the West, track the S&P 500, which is in the US, the most valuable 500 companies with very good returns. You can track that. And of course, it depends on which part of the world you are. Look for something that mimics the market as a whole. Therefore, you have a tech in every single company in that particular index. And in that way, you are well diversified. So that's the best advice I would give, that if you're starting out, it's best to just, you know, look for a bigger basket and track the whole thing. It helps with a lot of things. Number three, you have to create a diversified portfolio. I've done another video on this. You must be diversified. And that's why index fund investing can be good for beginners, in that you're buying into different companies. So for example, the S&P 500 have like Microsoft, Coca-Cola, Tesla recently, or is soon going into the S&P 500. All these big companies, you know, Apple and Amazon, all those amazing companies that you think of, they are all in the S&P 500. So it helps with the diversification. If you want to start investing, you must create a diversified portfolio. You must not put all your eggs in one basket, like they always say, because you don't want to lose every single thing just when you're starting. It can discourage you from investing and just sends you all scattered. So that's number three, create a diversified portfolio. Number four, you must be ready for downturn. Like I say, the market goes up and down. That is the nature of the market. If it was going up all the time, everyone would be a billionaire. Everyone would be investing. It wouldn't be a market anymore. But the essence of a market, the essence of a free economy, is whereby things happen and they affect the economy in negative or positive ways. So you must be ready that sometimes the investments will go down, sometimes the investments will go up. So be ready for all those emotions, know them, understand them, and learn them. Number five, try a simulator investing before you invest real money. Even though this is not so important according to me, because the simulator does not actually test your emotions like real investments do. I always say invest a little money and see how it goes before you get fully involved. But some people do say, you know what, try a simulator with fake money, basically, and then try investing it, see the returns, and before you get involved with the real money. This is basically just to cushion you against these emotions that come with investing. But in my opinion, it doesn't help us much, but you know what? Everyone to their own. If you like it, go for it. Do the simulator. They are for free every single place. Just open a brokerage account and try investing using a simulator. Number six, stay committed to your long-term goals. Now, this is extremely important. A lot of people want to invest and make quick money. It's not possible in the stock market. Forget about it, man. Just stay on track with the long-term goals. If you want to invest successfully in the market, do not be lied to that, you know, invest in this company is the next big thing, is the next Amazon, is the next Microsoft, is the next Apple. That's BS, man. What you do is simple. Have a clear plan of a long-term goal that you're gonna go with and stick by it. Do what you call dollar cost averaging, where you contribute every single month and ensure that you are very consistent with it. That's the only way you're gonna make money from the stock market. And that's the only way you're gonna ensure that you ensure yourself against the downturns of the market and against losses when you do trading in the market. We are talking about investing, not trading. If you wanna talk about trading, talk to me and I will give you more information about that and what to expect. Again, that is a different path. And that is, I say that's an income, that's not an investment. Number seven is to begin immediately. And this is very important. Start investing immediately. Start doing it now. Don't wait for tomorrow. Don't wait for a perfect opportunity. I started investing with like, I think $100 when I started my long-term investments. And yeah, you just start small. I didn't really care about it. I didn't really care that I had so little, while there were people talking about millions and millions of money in the market at the time. So what I did is, you know what? For me, that starting gave me pride. It gave me purpose. It showed me that I was taking a step. So yeah, start with whatever you want. Start with whatever you can. As little as possible. Even if it's just $50, depending on which investment you're buying, because some of them have minimum amounts. Start where you are and you're gonna make money at the end of the day. Like they say, the more time you have in the market, the better the compound interest effect will work for you. And the lesser the time, the more you may need to contribute in the future to make it to a particular goal. The best time is now, today. Number eight is you must avoid picking individual stocks. If you are a beginner, you do not understand and you do not have the knowledge to pick individual stocks. So let no one lie to you. Let no one tell you on YouTube that you are in a position to pick individual stocks. Forget about it, man. Just go with the index fund investing like I've advised, check out my video. I'll leave a link in the description below and see what index fund investing is. And of course, you can do more research on that. And what I say is stop picking stocks if you do not have the knowledge, the capacity, the time, and even the attitude to make that a success. So guys, if you are a beginner, forget about picking stocks, forget about buying individual stocks, just do what you call index fund investing. Invest in something that you know gives you proper diversification and does not expose you to so much risk. So do not start picking stocks because you're gonna lose big time. You're gonna learn the hard way. You don't want that, guys. You don't want that. Trust me, I've learned from experience. Number 9, and the last one, is avoid short-term trading. Now, like I said, there's trading, there's investing. Those two things are different. I always tell those who I'm training to do Forex trading or stock trading that these two things are completely different. So don't confuse one for the other. So if we say we're talking about trading, for example, it's trading, it can be day trading, swing trading, position holding, which position holding is more like investing actually, but the day trading or swing trading, these are short-term trading. They are not investing. So please, if you're a beginner in the stock market, avoid trading unless you have the capacity, the information, the training, the experience and the guidance, then you can do it. But the best way is to avoid trading if you are a beginner. Avoid short-term trading. Invest for the long term. Like I said earlier, stick to that long-term portfolio that you have. And these are some of the basic information, ideas that one needs to have for you to successfully invest in the stock market. So guys, stay tuned, more to come. And I hope you got some value out of this. Please, if you did, share the video, comment, like. Guys, let's push this message out there and let's grow together. Thank you and see you next time. Pssh.